does my builder actually work? Well, I have been testing my builder for the past month in a real life case study, and today I'm going to detail the results. Please note, I have no affiliation with my builder, and I will be sharing the good, the bad, and the ugly. Stay tuned if you want to see if my builder actually works in 2024. So, first up, I want to explain a little bit about what my builder actually is. So, my builder is a platform where potential customers find on the internet, they post the job that they need doing, and then that gets distributed across the My Builder network, and people can express an interest in it. And then should that customer want to take it further, they can do something called shortlist. So expressing an interest costs nothing, it's free. But once that customer shortlists you, that then means that you pay the fee for that job. My Builder's prices varies, as you can see on your screen right now. This job that I'm looking at here, they're going to charge me £5.40 if I get shortlisted. This one is £7. I'll show you a few examples. This one's £5.40. And it ranges anywhere from sort of £5 up to this one's £9.40. Some are 20 odd quid. Let's have a little look at this one. That one's £5. So they vary, and you only pay this if they shortlist you. But please note, just because they shortlist you, it doesn't actually mean that they're going to go ahead with the job. Most people, from my research over the last month, will shortlist 2 to 4 people, and then it's down to the company then to contact that customer and provide a quote or make the sale. So just to recap, you express an interest for free of charge, and then if you are shortlisted, which means the customer has selected you out of the how many other people have expressed interest, and quite frankly, some jobs get 1 or 2 people interested, some get 10 or 12. It's a very competitive market, but that's briefly how the model works. Next up, once you've expressed an interest, it goes into this second part of the system. So these are all of the jobs. As you can see, there's 54 results in here for the last month where I have expressed an interest in the job. Some of them here, you can see here, I've tried to highlight that, the interest has been declined. So that means that the customer on the other end hasn't selected me and they've declined my interest. And excuse me, what I'm finding is that because I'm new to this platform, I haven't got many reviews. So the decline rate is quite high at the moment, but I've been keeping an eye on a few people that have a lot of reviews and they get the shortlist a lot more often. So it's something that you're not instantly going to get results, but as you build the platform and build the reviews, that should improve. Then moving on, so once you've expressed your interest, if you get shortlisted, it drops into this little folder here. And this is where we get the contact details for that client. So at this point, we can message them through the system or we can contact them through the contact details provided. I forgot to mention that at the new lead stage, once you express an interest, so if I look at this one, this is one I've expressed an interest in, we can message that customer and I've got a template that we send out that goes out, and then hopefully they read that before shortlisting us, because like I said, once they shortlist us, we have to pay. So I try to express the interest, send them a message with any details so that I can save myself a few quid if they're not going to go ahead with me and they're going to go with somebody else. Then if you are shortlisted and obviously you contact the customer and you book that job in, you can press this request hire confirmation. So this just lets my builder know that they've hired you. The customer can do this without you requesting it, but I found that they forget. Basically, once their problem's sorted, they're not that fussed. So you press that button, it sends them an email, and then the customer confirms, and then that allows us to ask for a review. So once you've done that, and let's say hypothetically, we've done the job and we are asking for a review, we send the review, this goes into the job one. And then as you can see here, you can see the feedback that has been received. So that is pretty much all of it, apart from there is one other section here, so dead jobs. So this is where if a customer has declined us for whatever reason, you know, we don't get any feedback of why, this is just where it gets housed. And then if there's any leads that I physically decline that I'm not interested in, they would drop down into that bottom folder there. So that's a very quick overview, and I'm going to move on now to show you some of the results, good, bad and ugly. Let's start with what I've actually spent. So as you can see on the screen, I've got a few invoices here that are the charges that I've paid for the opportunity of the potential work through my builder. Not huge amount of money, because as I said, I'm not getting shortlisted for loads of stuff because I haven't got all the reviews that we need to be competitive yet. But I appreciate that it's going to take a bit of time to build that up. But in total, I think I've spent around £250. You can add it up if you like. It's in and around 250 quid I've spent in the month of February. And now we're going to move on to what actual results I've got. I've been tracking this very, very diligently. So I'm going to show you exactly how this has performed. Here we go. So these are the results. As you can see, I've been tracking this through my own software, which is called Sales Lion. One of the main reasons why I bought Sales Lion to market was to help other people be able to track what marketing's working and have the tools at their disposal to contact customers and win work. And it showcases this absolutely brilliantly. So this is live data up to today. And as you can see here, we have had a little bit of success. So in total, you can see that we have had 6 leads that have been turned into jobs, which is a total value of £775. So obviously I've spent 250 quid and I've obviously had to pay people to do these jobs. So the results aren't amazing, but they are profitable, which is ultimately the most important thing. But there's a lot of wasted leads as well, as you can see here. So this ghosted section means that we've sent them a quote and they've ignored us, or they haven't gone ahead. You can see here that 16 of those leads have ended up in that folder to a total value of potentially £5,500. So some of that work might trickle back in. And obviously if that does, then the results are even better. And as you can see, there's a few loose ends here. So we've got one here where we haven't been able to contact him, so he will get moved over to ghosted soon. This next one actually is in communication, which means we're in discussions. This is for a boiler swap, so if this comes in, it will transform the results from average to great for the spend. And then we've got a couple of quotes that have only just recently been sent, so we're just waiting to see whether the customer wants to go ahead. So based off of the numbers alone, I've spent £250 and it's produced a revenue of £775. So that revenue isn't profit, remember. So the time I factor in the labor that it has cost us to go and fulfill that work, there is a small profit of circa £200, okay? So based off that alone, I've spent 250 quid, I've got work in for the lads, and I'm left with a couple of hundred quid in as profit. So overall, it's average. I'm not blown away, I'm not disappointed, but what I also have is the opportunity cost. So that is very hard to fathom, but I now have the contact details for everybody that you can see in this customer journey that I've created on Sales Lion. So I can future market to them. Some of them may come back. They might not have had the money for the job. They may be getting other quotes. So I see that the one jobs are gonna go up. And based off of that, you know, I'm quite happy with the results, because like I said, we can market to these customers now. We have the potential of them drip feeding a few jobs in. And more importantly, I've got 6 happy customers now that are, hopefully, as long as we do our job correctly, are going to stay with us and use us again in the future. So for the 250 quid I've spent, I am pleasantly surprised. So I'm going to talk a little bit more now about some of the downsides to it. Okay. and then we'll move back to some positives. So the downside to this site is the consensus that I've come to is a lot of the potential customers on here are price driven, which isn't ideal. But that said, the climate, the world economy, everything that's going on at the moment, I think naturally most people are price conscious at the moment. It's not an area that I normally compete in. We're normally a premium price for a premium product. But as I said at the beginning of this video, we have been fairly quiet. So this has sort of reminded me that there is a huge market out there. And I know people criticize people that price things low and it's aggressive, but there is a market there and there's money to be made, because I have just shown it in the last month. And like I said, they're not blow away results, but I do see the results picking up and becoming better. So overall, I would probably say it is worth trying. If you're not stacked out, give it a try. Track the results and let the results make the decision. No excuses. Let's go.